guys. Thanks for tuning in to GCTV. I'm Colby Wilford here with Annalise Thompson.
GC senior Casey Ray recently signed on to continue her career on the next level. GCTV's Logan Whaley shares the details.
I played softball at Bethel University in McKenzie, Tennessee. I caught up with Graves County senior Casey Wade recently signed on to play softball at Bethel University in McKenzie, Tennessee. I caught up with Casey to get her thoughts and feelings about her recent signing.
It feels great. I'm really excited and I'm looking forward to it. I had offers from other colleges, but this is the only one that really stood out, and it's the only one that I wanted to go to that I knew about.
Casey cited that one of her main reasons for signing with Bethel was her relationship with head coach Larry Giraldi. Giraldi had this to say about Casey.
Casey is traditionally a pitcher. She also plays first base and hits well. And we look forward to her filling our needs on the mound. Next year I'll have a couple senior pitchers, and I look forward to Casey fitting in that mold and, of course, continuing her career at Bethel to help us have success on the field.
And for those that are interested, Coach Giraldi also mentioned the other opportunities that were offered at Bethel.
We are real strong on character, academics, and we also sponsor 32 sports, from bass fishing to inline hockey. So there's plenty of opportunities for young people to attend our university.
As always, for GCTV, I'm Logan Whaley.
Thanks, Logan. You're us, Casey. We know you do us proud.
Teachers, make sure you go by the Peel and Holland table in the PE Commons. They are set up this afternoon for supplemental insurance. If you don't get it done today, please make sure you do it tomorrow.
There will be a short homeroom tomorrow to distribute grade reports.
Anyone interested in ordering Young Democrat t-shirt, please see Ms. Seelock in room B06. The cost is $12.
Your FBLA offers are planning a FBLA trip to New York in January. Please see an officer or Mrs. Gaddis for more details. The deadline to sign up for this trip is October 28th.
The October FBLA meeting is Thursday, October 24th in the PAC. All members should make plans to attend. Important fundraising information and New York details will be discussed.
Graves County voters will now head to the polls on Tuesday, November 12th. That means we will be in school on Monday, November 4th, and out of school on November 12th.
Seniors, don't forget to schedule your headshots at Wells Studio for the yearbook. Wells is open Tuesday through Friday. You can call 247-1851 for your appointment.
Archery signups will be held through Tuesday during break in the PE Commons.
Boys basketball team will be waiting tables as a fundraiser at Carr Steakhouse tonight from 5 to 9 p.m. Come out and enjoy a great meal and help the boys basketball team.
The annual Turkey Trot 5K run is coming up on November 23rd at 9 a.m. It will benefit the Farmington Elementary 6th grade field trip. Entry fees are $20 for pre-registered runners and $30 for race day runners. You must pre-register by Saturday, November 16th.
Any girl interested in trying out for softball in the spring and not playing a winter sport, please attend workouts on Mondays and Wednesdays. Contact Coach Stan Waller if you have questions.
During the break, we got Kendra Guy with the sports.
And Matt Otto and Logan Sizemore share our first book reviews for We Weed Reek.
Blockbuster hit Hunger Games and never read the Hunger Games trilogy, now's the time. With the sequel hitting theaters November 22nd, I reread Catching Fire.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victors of the 74th Hunger Games, Katniss Everdeen and Peter Mallark.
She is. She just wants to save her skin. Simple as that. I agree she should die, but in the right way, at the right time. Katniss Everdeen is a symbol. We don't have to destroy her, just her image. Show them that she is one of us now. Let them rally behind that. They're gonna hate her so much, they might just kill her for you.
Just please, please, just help me get through this trip.
This trip doesn't end when you get back home.
So what do we do?
From now on, your job is to be a distraction so people forget what the real problems are.
Chins up, smiles on.
There she is, Captain 17! The girl on fire!
People are looking at you, Katniss. You've given them an opportunity. They just have to be brave enough to take it.
You saved my life. You gave me a chance.
Yes, to live.
No, to do something.
We have to go, Gale, before they kill us.
They will kill us.
Eradicated.
Her species, sir.
The other victors. Because of her, they all pose a threat. Because of her, they all think they're invincible.
This novel shortly follows the 74th Hunger Games, which was covered in the first book. Now that Katniss and Peeta's Hunger Games are over, they must go on a victory tour across all districts. What Katniss doesn't know is she inspires a rebellion among them. Many other events occur, and the third quarter quell, or 75th annual Hunger Games, takes place. Read it and find out what happens, because I think this is definitely a good read. All right, Suzanne Collins' Catching Fire, a 9 out of 10. For We Read Reviews, I'm Logan Sizemore.
Tonight for two of our sports programs. What's up, GC? The Lady Eagles volleyball team plays at the Eagles Nest tonight at Mayfield at 6. If the Lady Eagles come out with a win, they will play Battle Memorial right after at 7:30 for the district championship. Boys soccer team plays in the regional tournament tonight. The team heads out to Paducah Tillman to take on the Blue Tornadoes at 7:30. Friday night was a huge night for our football Eagles. They beat Christian County with a final score of 38-21. They clinched the district championship. This Friday, we have another district game. The Eagles host Hopkinsville, so come on out for senior night. That's all for the sports action. For Gctv, I'm Kendra.
Hey, GC, it's Andrew with the weather. Today will be sunny with the temperature being around 64. Tonight, there will be a 40% chance of rain with a low of 42. Tomorrow will be much like today, with a high being 63 and chances of showers at night. And Wednesday will be sunny with a high of 53. And that's your weather.
I'm Matt Otto, and for We Read Week, I have read Needful Things by Stephen King. The story takes place in Castle Rock, Maine, a small town where a new shop opens, Needful Things. Its owner, Wewin Gaunt, sells items at ridiculously low prices. However, the one who buys the item must play a prank on someone of Gaunt's choosing. Little do the inhabitants of Castle Rock know, Wewin Gaunt knows about the long-standing arguments and feuds in the town, and he uses the pranks as a means to elevate the tension to the breaking point. Overall, I'd give it about an 8 out of 10. For Reread Reviews, I'm Matt Otto.
There are tons of opportunities to improve your ACT scores. There are workshops before and after school.
Today, there is an after-school session on English at the Lead Academy building. Then tomorrow morning, there is an English session in the library.
Tomorrow afternoon, there is a reading session after school in the Lead building. Then Wednesday morning, there is a reading session in the library.
Wednesday afternoon, there will be a math session in room E31. Thursday morning, there will be another math session in the library.
Thursday afternoon, there will be a science session in room B08, and the final session will be Friday morning for science in the library. AM sessions start at 7 and PM. Sessions begin at 3:15.
There will be an FCA meeting tomorrow at 7:20 in Mr. Brown's room in B09. If you cannot make it, make sure to stop by Mr. Brown's room at some point during this week.
All-girl cheerleaders have their cookbooks for sale at $10 apiece. Contact a team member or one of the coaches, Cheryl Hawkins or Tina Nance, to purchase and help the girls raise money.
Power Cut football game will now take place Sunday, October 27th at 2 p.m. Admission to the game will cost $2 for adults and $1 for students. There will be a small concession stand. All proceeds will go to benefit St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital. Come out and support your team.
All Beta Club members need to come by Mrs. Robertson's classroom in B08 to sign the Beta Club t-shirt.
Young Republicans will have a meeting Thursday, October 24th.
The Lady Eagles basketball team is selling t-shirts. The cost is $10. If you are interested, please see Tracy Taylor at the front desk for an order form.
Keep calm and DECA on. This month's DECA meeting is tomorrow in room E34. DECA members can also pick up their Little Caesars pizza kits tomorrow after lunch.
FEA members going to the competition at Murray State tomorrow should check in to with their first block teacher before homeroom tomorrow. Then report to Mr. Mallory's room. Remember, only students have turned in all documentation will be allowed to go.
Well, that's all we have for today, guys. For GCTV, I'm Annalise Thomason.
And I'm Colby Wolford. Don't forget to go to homeroom tomorrow.